Oh, man, this one is nuts. And I'm kind of excited to talk about this one here real quick. This is crazy. I know we see high-speed chases and stuff all the time, man. But this one here, this just recently happened here, basically in my backyard. And I saw this, and I didn't even know this actually happened, tell you the truth. I just so happened to scroll across this thing and saw it here on YouTube. And I'm like, wait a minute, hold up. What the hell is this? This is from a local news channel here. Like I said, basically here in my backyard, here in my city. And I didn't see it then when they posted it, but this is dash cam video footage of this high speed chase. And as I said, I didn't see it from this news outlet because I don't watch this one particularly. Sorry about that, Channel 11. I don't. It's from WTOL. I watch Channel 13, but I only watch it in the morning for basically the weather. So I at least know what the weather's going to do for the day and the rest of the week, pretty much. That's about it, my extent of local news. So pretty much anything else I really don't pay attention to in local news. But this one here is pretty crazy because, like I said, I'm watching the dash cam footage and where they're chasing this individual, I know this stretch of road like the back of my hand. And it's wild. I'm like, dude, I know all this. I know exactly where this is at. You guys got to see this, man. This is pretty nuts from my point here. And you wait till the end. Watch this to the end because a state trooper got injured on this. So watch it. You just got to watch it to the end and see what happens here. All right. So anyway, let's get rolling with this.
They have a two-merry driver, for certain two-merry driver. I think they are behind that one. I'm right by the county unit now. I'll advise you shortly. Right, that's going to be a damage to the left front. Frank 1, John, 576.
All right, now, just to fill you in, state troopers got involved in this chase. This car was pulled over by a county sheriff.
It's in the right lane here, guys. Try to get it. That is the one. That is the correct one.
Right.
Right there.
It's the county sheriff right there.
Right
behind
that
there.
Over Oldsmobile now.
Yeah, there's county sheriff. It was supposed to be a traffic stop, I believe.
We got, are you out of the
state troopers got involved in this.
We're out of it now.
Righty.
Okay, what's your speed?
We're down to 49.
Now.
North of 162.8.
There's two missed opportunities. Count them. Where's the missed opportunity at? Where do you see this? Where do you see this? Right off the get him. Right there.
Where's me?
Right there. Hold up. Let me back it up real quick. Let me back this up real quick right here. And he pulls up right there. Missed opportunity. That vehicle should have been parked. He should have parked him. It was a rolling roadblock here is what they did. Got him trapped. He messed up. He screwed up because he didn't think about pulling that vehicle up farther. Pull it up farther up against the guardrail right there. That's a wide enough lane for that car to snake right through easily. Just floor and just step right through it. And you just saw what he just did. That was missed opportunity number one. Let's continue.
We're three with it.
Where's me?
Man, he should have cut him off.
From 163.
over here. Like I said, this is basically my backyard. I've been up and down this road for many years, up and down. I know that. I'm Flying J right there, truck stop. I know that. There's a distribution warehouse right there. They just put that up about 10 years ago, 12 years ago or so, 15 years ago. They just built that there.
165 northbound left lane.
So Home Depot distribution. I can't think of right off.
Speed just dropped down to 90.
It's like one of those things, you know, I see it go up building and just don't think anything about it.
Can be occupied by a single.
It's coming up on North Baltimore over here. I know North Baltimore. This is I-75 north here. It's the stretch road here. All of this. It's going to come up here on a petrol truck stop here on the right. Right here. It's coming up. It's coming up. Right here, just past the signs. See it right there? It's right there. That car is up there, man, but. This is here. They are now in North Baltimore right now, in the township of North Baltimore. Which North Baltimore is between Bowling Green and Findlay. If you know anything in this area here in Ohio, Northwest Ohio area here at I-75. Rolling, but guys, don't get it twisted, man. These state troopers' cars, they can roll, man. These things have, they can fly. You see here, he's gonna report a speed here, but they have to maintain a controlled speed, okay? They have to, because of just the danger of being at a high speed chase of that nature. They have to be at a maintained speed enough to make sure that they have total control of the vehicle. That car will push faster when he's running. You just said it had reached speed of 130 mile an hour. So that car can float, man. They can run. Right there. He could have pitted him and ended it right there, coming out of the ditch. Done. Been over. That's opportunity number two that was missed in this chase.
Get back on.
He even comes across radio and says he missed it. He should have took it. Roll that car, trying to pit at that speed. It's way too fast. see him. He's way up here a little bit. Watch, he's gonna catch him. Look at the dash cam. Look at the zipper, man. Look at that white line. See how he's moving fast enough, man. He's in it. He's getting in this thing. There he is. He's coming. He's right up here. That truck that just went by, okay? That one right there on the right that just went by. Pay attention to that. It's the other truck, the rest area here on the southbound side. It's getting ready to pull into the rest area here on the northbound side. Here, there's the other one on the northbound.
I'll take the exit. 10:30, be careful, you're in there alone right now.
I got blocked by a vehicle. He's back out, northbound.
Oh.
Disregard, he's running. Vehicle stopped, he's
down
in the woods.
Down on foot, he's running east in the rest area.
I don't know why the video froze. This isn't on my...
804.
This is on the video there. Dash cam.
403 is out in the area. They advise he's all in black clothes, running back towards 75.
All in black clothes, running back towards 75.
It's still recording. You see the lights over here.
Suspect in custody. That's Bowling Green 3.
This is nuts, man. That's crazy. It's not over yet. Just wait.
GPD has one in custody.
Just wait. It's going to be another dash cam view you're going to see here. Hold on. Right here. Remember that truck right there that was earlier? The first cop went by?
He's out on foot. He's out
wait
on foot.
Wait a minute. Wait for it. Oh!
31.
Oh!
Did you need medical?
Oh man.
Are you alright?
Yeah, I'm alright.
Okay.
Alright.
Okay. Need a squad?
Nah, I'm good, I think.
Check up.
Is 804 okay?
Yeah, I'm alright.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm okay.
1564
Friendly
Dispatch Squad.
Oh man, let me back this up again real quick. Real quick, like I said, pay attention to that guy that went by. They passed up. One right here. So watch again. He just passed him. This is the second dash.
He's out on foot. He's out on
passed
foot.
Him. Second trooper.
In the rest area.
Right here. Oh, God, dog, man.
804.
Right there. Hold on. I'm going to pause this right here. I got to say something about this. Now, I drive truck, okay? That's what I've been doing for many, many years. It's my daytime job. And then other work that I do, too, on the weekends, man. I guess I work 7 days a week, which I do. God. But anyway, I digress. that right there, I am going to basically, I'm going to give you my insight on this as far as what we saw right there on that accident. Was that avoidable? Yes. Was that an intense chase? That was pretty intense, man. Speeds like that, that's crazy. It's a good thing that that stretch of 75, like I said, I know like the back of my hand, most of that stretch is flat, straight and flat. It doesn't have any sharp turns as you see, as you saw in the video there. I mean, and that started, I think that started right before he got to Hancock County. And that's Finley's in Hancock County. So they claim it said it started in Allen County. I guess that's where the state trooper, or not state trooper, but the county sheriff started with that pursuit, I guess. Went into Hancock County, went through Hancock County, where this happened here right now, where he jumped out at. This is Wood County. All right. That right there in Bowling Green, actually, that, as you see the signs right up in front, that's Fostoria. That's the exit. That's Route 6. So way up there up front here. I didn't bring up my indicators here. But anyway, that's Route 6. Just north of that, maybe 2 miles north of that. I mean, even that's still, this is all Wood County, and then Bowling Green is right there. So if you know Bowling Green State University, BGSU, if you know any of that, if you don't, it's okay. That's fine. But like I said, all of this is all, but like I said, I know this entire area, like the back of my hand. I've traveled this road many, many days for many years. Like I said, with that semi right there, that steel hauler, his tags were up. His tag axles on his trailer were up. So that indicates to me he wasn't carrying a load. But still, not carrying a load, even with that trailer, with that many axles, that truck is still extremely heavy, still, okay? I'm guessing that truck there, you know, sleeper, along with that tag, and I know that bed has got to be aluminum, but the axles and everything add up to it. That truck empty is probably, I would guess, around 65,000 pounds, 65, almost 70,000 pounds. I would guess, with that weight. That's empty. That's not even saying the load it carries, because a load they can carry with that many axles, they can probably gross about 100. He'd be permitted to probably gross with steel. I'd say he'd be permitted to gross 160, 170,000 if he's permitted for that. I'd have to go over my jargon. You know, I mean, you guys wouldn't understand this stuff, and I'd have to go back and recalculate all that with the weight that's permitted on the axles. But, that was crazy. And like I said, that truck driver, he should have been paying attention. The officer himself is not going to walk away unscathed from this too. Okay. Cause I'm going to give him some criticism as well. But first, the truck driver should have been paying more attention about this, because he saw that high speed chase. Because remember when I said earlier in the video back there, I said, pay attention to that truck they just passed, because that's the one that just got in the accident. The one from the first guy, the first trooper on that first dash cam that went inside the rest area, when he was chasing him way back, and I said, watch that cam, because he passed that guy back there about north of Signet right there. Okay? So watch him on that, seeing all the lights. I'm just saying, when you see lights like this, man, this should be automatic. When you see lights flashing, patrol, you see a pursuit is happening, all right? Keep your eyes peeled for that. You see a state trooper involved. He just flew past you, blew your doors off. You saw the car, because that car had to pass you too. You knew who he was chasing. Okay. Keep your eyes peeled for that. You should know this. If you've been driving truck long enough, which I'm sure that steel hauler probably, he might have been driving truck long enough, should have been paying more attention, honestly. And just keeping his eyes peeled, looking in his mirrors back and forth, you know, either side. You should be checking your mirrors anywhere from, like, you know, some say 8 to 10 seconds, 10 to 15 seconds. Should be checking your mirrors constantly. So with that, he screwed up on that, because the simple fact is, you see those lights inside that rest area in there, man. Dude, there's more coming. There's more. Keep your eyes peeled. There's more cops coming. You saw that car fly by. And it's just one cop car involved in that, a state trooper involved in that chase. Oh, no, there's multiples at that speed flying like that. Expect to be two or three, okay? At that point. Now, to the officer, the officer, you know what? I can understand his adrenaline pumping and everything in that chase, because those speeds were intense, man. They were very, very high, because I'm sure he was involved in that too, right behind his partner that took the lead. Those guys are rolling, man. Even the guy taking the lead, his partner's right behind him running about the same speed, just about. I would guess he would stay. He'd have to stay about the same speed just to keep up with the chase in case the lead is disabled, incapacitated, whatever happens to the lead, he can still possibly continue to pursue. So with that, that being said, him cutting in front of that truck, like I said, adrenaline's pumping, man. You're not thinking clear to a degree and not understanding just because your lights are on and sirens. I'm sure he forgot that he passed that semi right there in that lane. That semi never come out of that slow lane right there. So I'm sure it didn't cross his mind till it was too late. And maybe it didn't cross his mind. Maybe just assume that semi truck driver's going to pull over. Anyway, don't assume. I'm sure something was said about that, because that car is done. That car is toast. Okay. It didn't explain any more into the details of this video as far as what involved with the semi truck and the state trooper here. Maybe I'll hear something about it later, but this just happened a little over a month ago. I didn't know anything about this high speed chase here. I heard of another high-speed chase, because we get them around here every once in a while. I mean, it's just not like it's slow around here. We get high-speed chases around here almost frequent. You know, it is what it is around this place, I guess. But that was intense right there, man. That was intense. But like I said, he should have been paying more attention to it, because you could have avoided that accident. Truck driver should have been paying more attention, checking his mirrors to see what was going on, if any other cars was coming around him. It's, you know, like I said, state troopers, county sheriffs, local township, anybody with lights on like that, with that much noise going on, something is going on here. Pay attention, man. Creep. Do, you know, be on high alert. Be on high alert with that. As I said, trooper screwed up too, because I think he assumed that that truck driver is going to pull over. But even then, I don't even think he assumed he's going to pull over. I just think he forgot that he passed that truck driver and passed that semi and wanted to duck in and, you know, and join in on the pursuit as far as a foot pursuit is looking for the suspect there. I think he forgot that semi truck was coming. And he pulled in front of him so quick, there's no way truck driver is going to stop. Even like I said, even if his truck was empty, which, like I said, I saw his tags up, truck was empty. So, and that truck is still heavy, man. And it's not going to stop on a dime, man, when your empty weight is 70,000 pounds, okay, or more. I would say he's pushing 70,000+. So, yeah, that's crazy, man. That is nuts to see that. But anyway, let me know what you think. That was intense. That was very intense. And I just kind of got, I got giddy over this. I'm like, oh, whoa, wait a minute. What is this? This is in my backyard. Wait a minute. This is going down the road. I know about almost every single inch of that road, man, going all the way past Finley, you know, going south. It's like, I know that highway. I know all of that highway. This is crazy. I didn't know anything about it. So anyway, pretty nuts seeing something happen in my backyard like that. I'm like, oh my God, I know all of that. Wild. But let me know in the comments below, what do you think about this, man? Was the truck driver, I need to know, do you think the truck driver should have been paying more attention to slow down and stop? Or do you think the officer should have been paying more attention and remembered that that truck was there in that lane? That it's hard to do this, man. When you're running on a high-speed chase like that, it is so hard to keep up with every single thing that's going on. So mistakes were made. Truck driver is okay. I mean, the trooper's okay. He's fine, mainly. I ain't worried about the truck driver. I'm sure he's just fine, you know. I mean, his truck is jacked, but he's just fine. Trust me. The trooper, man, I'm just glad he said he's okay. He checked out. So far, I don't know. Like I said, until they get a squad out there, get the EMT and check him out. There's no detail about that. But as long as he didn't get injured, that's fine. Truck driver, He's fine, too. Trust me. You'll be all right. That much truck, you'll be all right. So, anyway, that's crazy, dude. And like I said, I drive the big rigs as well for a long time. Lord knows I'm trying to retire. But anyway, let me know in the comments below. Guys, if you like the video, I appreciate you. You know what? Everything else, thumbs up, the whole deal. It helps the algorithm, helps move my channel up. You know, I appreciate you guys. If you like it, subscribe, man. Thanks a lot. I will see you on the next one.